All I can say is that, the fake news just doesn't get it, do they?
His hands do a lot of interesting things there, but I agree with him. They don't get it. And you know who does get it? Curtis Houck, managing editor of Newsbusters. Welcome back, Curtis. How are you?
Good to be with you, Greg.
Curtis, I actually think that the media, they are potentially doing real damage to the lives of people right now. Here's my theory. They should be covering the recount situation, the voter fraud allegations, more responsibly, because they're pretending it's a false story. In the event that this election is overturned, there are going to be a lot of very angry people. And I think they're going to be angrier because they're going to be surprised. They're not going to see it coming because so much of the media are not reporting it honestly. And then we could have some real violence on our hands.
Right. I think I agree with that. I think my mind goes to what are the media doing right now? They're trying to say that Donald Trump is going to cause another 9/11 or he's going to invade another country right now. So the media right now aren't doing very well, Greg. They're just really flailing all over the place. We saw before the election, you and I have talked about how the media ignored Tony Bobulinski. If they could just pretend it didn't happen, they could put, you know, their fingers in their ears and, you know, la, 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 like in Dumb and Dumber, just to pretend that something isn't happening. But of course, what is going on is it is happening. That, you know, Georgia announced that we're going to do a hand recount of all the votes. You know, you got the update earlier in the show from Jason Miller. This is a real thing, people. You know, some people are pulling, I saw that Decision Desk has retracted their call of a congressional race in New Jersey because of votes breaking for the Republicans. So this is going on all across the country right now. And yeah, the media's first responsibility is the who, what, where, when, why, and how. And when you're failing to do that, you're not a news media. You're a propaganda outfit.
Yep. Hey, you mentioned 9/11, that they're trying to say that this transitory time could lead to a 9/11 type thing. You're not exaggerating. This happened on NBC Today. You pointed this out for us. I think this is Peter Alexander, their White House guy. One of them. Let's play it.
In 2000, the legal fight over less than 600 votes in a single state, Florida, delayed the transition between the Clinton and Bush administrations by 37 days. The 9/11 commission that examined the 2001 terror attacks found that loss of time slowed the Bush team from identifying, recruiting, clearing, and obtaining confirmation for key appointees.
The implication being that it all led to 9/11, and this could do the same thing. I don't know why they talk about it like that, but we'll talk about that some other time. Clearly a stretch, Curtis.
Yeah, and as someone who's currently actually reading the 9/11 Commission report on my coffee table right now at home, I can confirm that, yes, if folks recall, that there were a number of problems going into 9/11. So for the media to pretend that that was the biggest issue and the reason that 9/11 happened is just preposterous. I think, Greg, the bigger point is it's an insult that the news media are doing to our military men and women, that somehow because of who's president of the United States, that their military readiness, their intelligence gathering is somehow at fault because Orange Man Bad is still in the White House and Joe Biden isn't able to control the levers of power yet. I mean, I think, again, it's an absolute disgrace and an insult for people to be doing this on Veterans Day of all days to say that our military men and women somehow aren't able to do their jobs right now.
Well, Mark Esper, the Secretary of Defense, who nobody could pick in a lineup with a gun to their head, is suddenly off the job. Like, that means anything to anybody? It's the biggest bureaucracy in the world. By the way, the 9/11 Commission report, which I actually recommend everybody should read it. I read it cover to cover. Check out the part where they say Congress actually has blown off its oversight responsibilities in favor of scandal, media attention, media grabbing stories. That was a significant contributor, that Congress took its eye off the oversight ball. That's in there too, Curtis. Hey, by the way, what is all that stuff behind you? It looks like you're in a doctor's office. What is that stuff?
We're in our Newsbusters conference room. Behind me is copies of Newsweek and Time magazine going back into the 80s since the MRC started in 1987. Oh, so if you want to know something, we have it for you.
Okay, good. Actually, that's very good to know. To be continued, Curtis Houck, check out Newsbusters. We'll be right back.